Hello and welcome to this session on SoapUI beginner tutorial. Today we are going to see what are the different options we have to run a project in SoapUI. So we are going to see how to run a project from the GUI of SoapUI, how do we run a project with the help of a Groovy script, and then we will see how to run a project from command line. And we will also discuss some tips during this session. So let's get started and let me open my SoapUI. So the SoapUI is up and I will just close this startup page here. And here is the project that we have been working on. I will expand this project and I will just double click on this project here. And you can see we get this window for the project. The very first tab is overview, which gives us the project summary, the location where this project file is saved, all the test summaries, test suites, the count of test suites, test cases, test steps, assertions, load tests, etc. And then we have a property section here. And then if you go to test suites, here you have the option where you get all the test suites inside this project, and then you have the option to run it with the help of this green play button. And also you have options to run all the test suites in sequence, so that will run it one by one. And in case you want, you can run all the test suites in parallel by selecting this option. So I will just select this option and then hit the play button, and you can see it is running all the test suites. And because all of them failed, therefore the final status is a failure. And also you can go to test suite logs, and here you can see logs disabled during parallel execution. So in case you are doing parallel execution, the logs will not be generated. But if I select here sequential execution and then run it, you can see the logs are getting generated here. So this is how you run your project from the GUI of SoapUI. And now let us go to the next interesting topic of running from a Groovy script. So for that, what you can do is, let me open any of the test suites and let me create a Groovy step. So I will say add step and I will add a Groovy script here, and I will name it as run test project and say OK. And here we have got the editor. And to save some time, I have already added some notes for Groovy script. So you can see this. This is the command, or this is the code to run a project with the help of Groovy script. I will add it here, and all these notes will be available in the description section of this video. So here, what we are going to do is, we are first storing the project into a variable called project name, and we are saying testrunner.getTestCase.getTestSuite.getProject.getWorkspace, and then we have to get the project by name and then give the project name. Now in this case, I am not selecting the same project inside which we have this Groovy script. Otherwise, if we do that, it will keep on running the project in a loop. So what I'm doing is, I have this sample project here, a REST project. I'm just selecting this, I'm giving the name of this project here, and then I'm just saying project name dot run null true. So null is actually a property, and you can use this property here, which is string to object map. However, you can, if you do not want to do this conversions, you can just say null, and you can say true or false, which is for asynchronous run. So for now, I will just keep it as it is, and I will just say, I will hit this play button, and you can see it is getting executed. So did you see this REST project got executed? Also, what I can do is, this particular run I can store in a variable. So I will say def run status, and here I can actually print this. I will say log.info, and I will say status is, and I will copy this run status variable here, and from here I will say, I will get the status and I will convert it to string, and I will try to get this. And if I run it now, you can see the status I am getting is running. So what I will do is I will add some sleep. Let me add a sleep of, let's say, 6 seconds, and run it again. And now you can see the status is finished, right? So this is how you can run your project from the Groovy script. And now let us look at the third topic, which is running from command line. And running from command line is as straightforward as running from Groovy script, and in fact we have seen in the earlier sessions as well how we run it from command line. So what you have to do is, whenever you want to run any element from command line in SoapUI, do a right click. So in our case we have to run this project, so I will do a right click here and select launch test runner. So we have our test runner here, so just click here, and here you get this test runner window. Now here you can see we have these options. If you want to run all the test suites inside this project, you can select all, or you can select some particular test suite. So in my case I will say all, because that is when the entire project will get executed. And of course I am selecting test cases as all. And here you have some other options, and in case you want to get the reports, you can select the reports and give a location where you want to store the reports. In case you have any properties or arguments, you can give it here, and then just hit this launch button, it will start. You can actually cancel this, because what we want is this commands that is getting generated. So the first thing is we have to go to the bin location of SoapUI, and this is similar what we did for test cases and for test suite. So let me also put it in the notes, command line run. This is the first thing, you will cd or change directory to SoapUI bin, and then this is the command which starts from testrunner.bat, and I will copy this line and again go to my notes and paste it here. So you can see the command is testrunner.bat, and this is the option to create the report and the location of reports, and then finally the location of our project. So if you notice, in the earlier sessions when we have run for test suite, the only difference is we give the minus s tag or option and give the test suite name. In case we want to have the test cases, we can give minus c and give the test case names. But here, because it is for the entire project, we are not giving any such minus s or minus c for test suite or test cases, and then we are having the same command. So you can just now copy this, go to your command prompt and paste it. So first I'm changing the directory to SoapUI bin, and then I will just copy this and run. So this will actually run all the test suites inside this project, and all the test cases and all the test steps. And now in case you do not want to execute some particular test suite or a test case or a test step inside a test case, then you can always disable that. For example, you can just right click and disable that particular test step or a test case or a test suite, and that will not get executed. So now you can see this is getting executed. And also if you see the location where you have selected to create the logs, you will get all these logs and reports getting generated. Okay, so wherever there is a failure, you will get a report getting generated, and you can troubleshoot this. So this is how you can run your project from GUI, from Groovy script, and from command line. I hope this session was very useful for you. I will meet you in the next episode of SoapUI. Thank you for watching.